Good evening, everyone. Thank you so much for joining today's Rennington virtual session. The topic for today's session is enabling full visibility for zero trust networks. The speaker for today is Mr. Ravi. During the session, if you have any questions, please put them in the Q&A tab on the left, and they'll be answered at the end of the session. Ravi, over to you, please.
Okay, thank you, Chanakya. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for joining today's session. And as Chanakya mentioned, so today's agenda is enabling full visibility for zero trust network. So what I'm going to discuss today is about the zero trust network, how to achieve it, and what are the challenges that one face when they try to implement the zero trust network. And lastly, I will talk about the SSL Insight, that is our A10 product, which helps the customer for encryption and decryption, and how it will help the customer to achieve the zero trust network. So let's get started. So these are just numbers that I have put in the slide to begin with. As you can see, that you might have heard about it on the different digital platform, that this kind of attacks is going on, and these are the research paper that different organizations have conducted. And what we gather is that average cost on the enterprise per data breach is around 4 million. There are a lot of percentage increase in the Trojan-based malware attack. And breach is caused by the phishing and also because of the stolen credential. So these are some of the data that we have gathered for 2019 across the world. And what is the impact of these data breaches? It's of course ransomware, then the brand damage, the loss of revenue, fines related to GDPR, and you might get involved into the lawsuit or the investigation as well. Just for example, 2019, there was a devastating blow to the Facebook. Almost 20% of the Facebook's 2.3 billion users, that is around 490 billion from 2.3 billion. That is like 20% of the users. Several unprotected database of that discovered online of the Facebook user, that is reported by one of the company, the research company. The database were found on a server and had no password protection in place, which meant they were freely accessible to anyone anyone has the internet connection. So this is one of the biggest breach that occurred last year, just for the information I'm sharing. And what is the impact is, of course, going to have the brand damage. There might not be a complication related to data loss, but it will greatly impact the brand of our enterprise company. So what are these attacks? Are these attacks launched from outside? Of course, yes. But more often, internal threat actor are to be blamed for such attack. Any user within the trusted internal network has a legitimate access to the resources, has a conscious intent to cause a harm. So who is an internal threat actor? A malicious insider or a disgruntled employee, an imposter who technically is an outsider, a corporate spy? So this kind of internal threat that is there right now. And internal threat actors are generally, they are not aware of the damage they are causing, or though this kind of internal threat actor, they has no conscious intent of causing a harm to company, just because of the careless and negligence of the IT security that poses or that they have, and because of that they become the internal threat. So how to prevent this? And this is what I'm going to talk about, which is the zero trust. So of course, the zero trust means to trust no one. So again, it's been there for a very long time, but it's a conceptual model driving an architectural change. And it's been there for very long for a different vendor and customer, but they are finally implementing this model. This zero trust model it demand a more architectural change. And in zero trust model, visibility is the key. Visibility into the users, into the data, into the workflow, and so on. So this is what the zero trust that we, it's on the higher level. So what is the basic principle of the of zero trust? It is to trust nobody. You need to redesign the network into a secure micro parameter level, limit the excessive user privilege, improve detection and response time, through analytics and automation, enable compliance, improve security detection and response with centralized visibility and control center, avoid solutions that are too complex to deploy and use, then avoid solutions that don't support diverse integration. So these are some of the points that can help you to achieve the zero trust. Now, when we are talking about the zero trust, as we know that more than 90% of the traffic of the internet is on the encrypted traffic. So encryption introduces new challenges and complexity to achieve the zero trust. And of course, it gives you the privacy, but it can also hurt your security. That we'll discuss how it can hurt your security in the later part of this session. So these are the data that we have gathered from the Google report, transparency report. You can go onto website and check that transparency report. So when we talk about encryption, it also it's also at the blind spot, because it as is encrypted, traffic is encrypted, you don't have any visibility into that. So according to Google, 94% of the traffic right now is encrypted traffic. Then from 2015 it was around like 55%, and by to 2020 when we are talking, it has reached to 94%. And what is more important is more than 40% of the cyber attack abuse SSL encryption. And as you can see that around 45% of the malware were sent through the encrypted. They were encrypted malware or they were sent through the encrypted channel so that the security device can't detect it. So how the traditional defense fail due to this SSL blind spot that has been caused by the encryption. So different security devices are meant to tackle different phase of a cyber attack. And here I have include three main phase which any targeted attack or any hacker will indulge in. So first attack is the infiltration. So this is a stage where an attacker is either actively targeting your network and trying to install the malware or gain access. Or when an insider actor or the employee accidentally download an infected file and click a malicious link. Here, the email or website involved may be encrypted, which would lead to your traditional IPS, IDS, firewall, antivirus or the software, SWG devices, secure web gateway like this device, being blind to this hidden threat. And when we talk about the command and control stage where the malware has started to execute and is trying to establish a connection to the server as well as being spread laterally through the network. The CNC communication can also be encrypted, and unless the traffic is decrypted, there is no way this communication can be tracked or stopped. And last stage is of course exfiltration. This is the last stage at which point the malware has spread throughout your network, has established the communication to the server, is aware about the critical files that is need to smuggle out, destroy or encrypt in case of attacks like ransomware where data is held for ransom. And traditional DLP device will fail here without having visibility into the encrypted traffic. Forensic device without visibility into the encrypted traffic won't be able to provide the full picture and analysis. So zero trust model will also fail without decryption, because visibility is the key. But when we talk about the visibility, it requires more than the simple upgrades. So existing solution is not enough. Even if you are going to put a, for example, let's say firewall, you implement it to be a decryption device. As per NSS slab, typically a next generation firewall experience, up to 90% of the performance degraded with the decryption, which means, let's say if your firewall does 80 Gbps throughput pre-decryption, you will need 10 firewall to match the original promised performance of 18 Gbps throughput. That is, if we assume no load balancer are used. And on top of that, decryption, when we talk about, it's the key, as we already discussed, as I already discussed, to achieve the zero trust. As you can see here, this orange line indicate the encrypted traffic and the blue line indicate the decrypted traffic. So you have the secure web gateway, which is sending a decrypted traffic to the DLP for the data loss prevention. Then you have all the other module, which is doing their own encryption and decryption. When you do that, it is going to reduce the performance of each individual security device. So as we can see, there is no single point for decryption policy control and key management. There is a separate decryption license that might you require on different devices if there is any. Then expensive upgrade will require to scale with the rising demand, that as I mentioned, that the throughput of the devices of firewall reduced to 90% when you enable the SSL encryption and decryption. So what's the solution? Whether you want to degrade your performance on each appliance, or you want to disable TLS SSL inspection, which is actually not feasible in today's world, because you won't be able to see the data, you won't be able to protect your data, because you can't see anything, then you can't protect it. So the solution is the dedicated and centralized encryption that provides full visibility to entire security infrastructure. It enhances efficiency of existing security infrastructure, is a vendor agnostic, and provide flexible deployment option. Is easy to operationalize and easy, and the use, and provide centralized visibility and analytics. Also should be provide centralized management, and so is decryption policy and key management control. So let's talk about the A10 solution, that is, and what it has to contribute to the decryption that we talk. So we provide SSL Insight, which is a dedicated decryption solution. Of course, it has a dedicated hardware appliance. Actually, it's a dedicated hardware appliance which decrypt traffic at a very high rate, it gives you high throughput because it hardware accelerated, it gives you best performance out of it. And SSL Insight is at the core of the zero trust model, because it gives you the visibility. With most of the internet traffic, as we discussed, has been encrypted, this will enable other zero trust security devices and improve their efficiency as well. Also gives you the multi-layer security service that will enable you to achieve your compliance, restrict and scrutinize the user access to the different services on the internet, or provide the consolidation of the multiple security service in one platform. And when we talk about SSL Insight, the Forrester has mentioned specifically its ease of use, that is Meta, and A10 SSL is really easy to use because it gives you centralized visibility and management and the policy control with uniform GUI that help position us as a stronger contender. And of course, we can seamlessly integrate with other security solutions so that you will be able to see the traffic. So we can enhance the performance with the secure decrypt zone. Before that, the SSL, as we already see that how the traffic was, each device was encrypting and decrypting the traffic, and it was actually reduce the performance of the device. So what we can do, we can eliminate the blind spot. Then by enabling your security device to detect and stop hidden threat. Because of that, we can also ensure the compliancy and privacy. And by doing that, ensuring the compliancy with security and the privacy standard like HIPAA, PCI and GDPR. And because of that, if we do that, we can increase the ROI as well and secure your investment by eliminating the blind spot that affect your existing security devices. So the solution that we have, I'm going to deep dive into the A10 Thunder SSLI. It has mainly three pillars, I would say, which I will discuss in detail about each pillar, which is full traffic visibility, multi-layer security, analytics, and ease of use. So let's talk about the full traffic visibility. So this includes the PFS at industry's highest performance. We can decrypt across the multiple protocols, including SSL TLS, SSH, START TLS, XMMP, SMTP, and POP3. We can also do the dynamic port inspection to identify and decrypt the SSL TLS over any port. So that means no traffic can be hidden and there is no blind spot. We also provide the full proxy architecture that ensures the granular control over the traffic. And SSLI inside is non-disruptive, integrated seamlessly into any network. We can be deployed as a layer 2 bump in the wire or L3 device and can be deployed as a transparent or explicit proxy as well. Decrypt once and inspect many times. So that is what we do. Because once we decrypt, you can send the traffic to the multiple security devices. And because we are also flexible into interoperability, we support inline passive or the passive model as well, or we can do the ICAP enable. We can support ICAP enabled devices as well. We works with transparent and explicit proxy. We support proxy chaining for connecting to the upstream proxy as well. And service chaining can be used to steer traffic through different security devices based on source, destination IP, addresses, protocol type, user or group ID, and application ID. So we can do the traffic steering as well. So what goes into the secure decrypt zone? So of course, these are the logos of only some of the our validated security partner that we are showing here. You can have the firewall like a Cisco, the sandboxing device like FireEye, multi endpoint solution or the server security solution like Trend Micro, and Fidelis, McAfee, and so on. So all these devices which have, just for the example, I have mentioned it here. And when we talk about the compliance, to achieve the compliance, it is a very difficult task. We can selectively bypass for the compliance with privacy regulation like HIPAA, SOX, PCI. We can decrypt the traffic to stop data breaches and ensuring the GDPR compliance. That will ensure our organization is safe from large fine and lawsuit. High speed and detailed logging for the PCI and DSS compliance. For example, healthcare website, due to HIPAA regulation, then we can bypass the personal financial data due to EU GDPR regulation. So that is also possible, that not to scan everything, not to decrypt everything. So we have the web classification service integrated into the SSLI. More than 83 sites category is there in order to decrypt and also to bypass. Onbox database of around 220 million domains entry and 600 million domain in the cloud is there, which is powered by our web root. So this is the first pillar that I discuss. Now let's talk about the second pillar, which is multi-layer security. So SSLI Insight is not a simple decryption solution. It comes with a number of different security features and services that can be used to enhance the security of your network, creating an additional layer of security in addition to the secure decrypt zone. Now, this is just a snapshot of some of the advanced security features that we support on SSLI. Of course, some of the features they do require the additional license as well, that we can discuss it if you have any requirement. Let's talk about the application visibility that you will get with the application firewall feature. There are rules that can be applied when the first packet comes into the SSLI, and we can filter it by the application with tag ID. We support more than 3000 application spread, which is spread across around 39 categories. Now this category include the examples such as web, file management, gaming, e-commerce, social, and so on. An application can be belong to more than one category at the same time. For example, with app visibility, FB web, Facebook web, it can be allowed, while Facebook video can be blocked, while at the same time Twitter video can be allowed, and so on. So customer wants to view a visual representation of all the application being accessed through SSLI path, that you can get it. Now this feature, of course, it requires the add-on license that we can with our firewall. Then the second is the threat investigator. So it's a very good tool that will give you the insight of the specific applications or the specific website that is there. You can explore it. You can get the analytics out of the specific website or the application. You can get the threat map out of it, and so on. So this is really useful for the analytics purpose and give you the insight of the any website or the application. Then we have the, of course, URL and web filtering is straightforward. Your category we can match by the SNI certificate issuer or the certificate subject as well. So as I mentioned, we have around 83 categories, and you can block the malicious content whichever website is there. We have identified the risky website which can be blocked easily, and you can get the granular control by user ID and group ID. You can create a filter out of it. Next is the ICAP security support. So ICAP request mode is for the DLP appliances, and the response mode for the antivirus and the malware appliances. We have pre-filter of traffic based on request method, payload, or the preview length. So ICAP support, you can integrate with any appliances which supports the ICAP. Then lastly, the threat intelligence. So compromised systems, spammers, botnet, malware, then command and control infrastructure, open DNS relay, then there are geographical blacklisted IP address, ransomware servers, and more. Thunder SSLI use this list to block access to malicious source. We have this much of amount of data, and this thing you can apply it through the firewall rule, which is our CFW firewall, Thunder firewall. You can apply this rule and block all the access to the malicious data which is we already identified. And lastly, the user based policy. So We have our platform is the ACoS platform. So we can provide the integration, consolidates the multiple authentication point for simplified access management and the single sign-on. Yes, that is also possible so that you don't have to use the different username and password. And all this thing, it can be logged through the SIEM solution for the extensive log tracking capability. And you can then do the forensic on the specific log. The third pillar, which I want to discuss, is the analytics and the ease of use. So when we talk about the ease of use and simplicity, we have full feature parity with the previous version of the SSLI expect for the troubleshooting. And when we talk about visual appealing design, it's really easy to use, and you will be able to configure the device by our wizard option. And whenever you try to configure any IP address, you will get the live information on the wizard option itself. If, for example, if you type the IP address of any network interface, you will get that into this network diagram. Here you can see there is a E1 is a network interface of the SSLI. So for example, if you click next and configure the IP address, it will appear here automatically. So again, this is really easy, and there is only 3-step configuration is required. And wizard-based simplification, which is what makes the SSLI easy to use within from months to days to minutes. Within the minutes, you can configure the SSLI. Then we have the, as I mentioned here, this is what you can do. If let me just zoom in. So this is L2 deployment mode. Here you can configure it. And you can also get the troubleshooting of the configuration in the GUI itself. And let's talk about the intuitive dashboard and detailed visibility. So you can, of course, customize the dashboard. You can add the widget and tile, and you can group by the service. You can get the detailed logs out of it. There is the instantaneous report is also available on the device itself. So you can get more data out of it. So these are some of the examples of the dashboard and the widget that we have. And these are the logs that can be exported. And most importantly, you can get the centralized management and the visibility through our Harmony control. So that's again a separate dedicated device, which is to manage multiple A10 devices from the central location. So if some customer is spread geographically and wants to use the device on the different location and want to manage it from one central location, that is possible with our Harmony controller. And in Harmony controller, we have the SSLI app, which can streamline the everything, and you will get all the device information at one central location. Everything what we can do from each single appliance, you can do it from the Harmony Control app and configure it from one central device location. These are some of the analytics that is there on the Harmony controller, and this is how you will get the application visibility, as you can see, with the amount of traffic that has been hit for the different application traffic. You will get all the information here. And lastly, the enhanced logging. So we can generate the logs. This graph is generated by the Splunk SSL Insight app. So you can integrate into the third-party SIEM solution or the Sixel solution and get this kind of really intuitive information, which will help the customer to identify where the traffic is going. It will give you the deep visibility into the network, and then they will be able to do the actionable task. So comprehensive SSL logging instead for we can give you for all SSL session, which shows the detailed traffic and the connection statistic. And in Splunk, you will get a dedicated enterprise app as well for the SSLI. This is how we have created this dashboard, which you can see here. So what is the next step is the We have some professional service available for the SSL Live with multiple service package, and you get the 24/7 support. There is also training and available for the SSL Live any of the customer want, and there is a dedicated team for the incident response and management, which of course the enterprise customer can purchase and have the they can leverage this team to identify any incident that has been occurred. So this is what you can do next. If you have any requirement, then you can get into touch with us. And you can, of course, go onto our website, read about the solutions, what is the deployment guide in there, watch the videos, and what are the common threat hiding behind the SSL encryption. Everything you will get on SSLi on the ATEN website. So this is it from my side. If you have any questions, guys, then let me know. I'm here. Okay, guys, you can leave if you want a video. It will be uploaded to our YouTube channel. You can go there and watch again if you want. Thank you very much for your time.